go to the sample database, new query, go to tables, scroll down, and you can see the table production.product, and this is the table we are going to use in this scenario as the first table. So let's query this table production.product and see the columns and data within this table. Hit run. Product ID and name are the two columns we are interested for this scenario. So let's rewrite this query including only these two columns, product ID and name. You can see only the two columns in the output. Let's go to the requirement. You want to find the sales orders for all product IDs along with the product ID and its name. So you need to get the sales orders for all the product IDs in this table production.product. So the product ID, name column are there. You need to display the sales order next to it. So to get the sales order details, you need to go to a second table. Just scroll down. So the second table is going to be the sales order detail, from which you can get the sales order details. Let's query this table and see the columns and data within this table. Sales.SalesOrderDetail. Sales order ID and product ID are the two columns we are interested from this particular table, but you can't see any product name in this table. If you see the requirement, sales orders needs to be displayed along with the product ID and name. The name is the product name, but you can't find any product name column in this table sales order detail. You have to get the name information from the table product. So now we'll rewrite this query using the two columns, product ID and sales order ID. So product ID and sales order ID, we got it in the second query. And in the output, you can see only the two columns. The first one, you can see two columns. And here also, you can see the two columns. But in the first query, along with the product ID and name column, we need to display the sales order ID. So we'll copy this one, the first table. And give an alias name A for the table product. So we have two columns, product ID and name from the table production.product. So we are including the alias as prefix. Sorry, it's A.name. So you got the first column and the second column from the table product. Next, we are going to do a left join with the table sales order detail. Give an alias B for the sales order detail. So if you see the two tables, you can see the product ID column common to both of them. So we are going to do this left join based on the common column, product ID. So this product ID is from the product table. And this product ID is from the second table, sales order detail. So we got the two columns from table A, and we need to include the third column from the table sales order detail, and that is going to be the sales order ID. So we got the required three columns, and we combine these two tables using a left join based on the common column product ID. Let's execute this one, click run. You can see all the product IDs and the sales orders for those products. So you can see some null values for a few product IDs. But if you scroll down, you can see the product IDs and the sales orders associated with them. And you can see the product ID name along with the sales order IDs.